This could be some sort of brilliance from the LA Galaxy, a miniature version of what Atlanta United did with Miguel Almirón. The Galaxy are said to be willing to purchase 70% of Muchtis Ayat Christian Pavon for $12 million, putting the 23-year-old Boca Juniors playmaker in 9x capped Argentine on the books for his former coach Guillermo Barros Schelotto. More transfer rumor round up that $12 million figure somewhere between half according to Transfermarkt and a lesser fraction of what Pavon is expected to one day fetch from any number of suitors including Arsenal. Milzocker.com suspects that the Galaxy would cut ties with injured Romain Alessandrini in order to add Pavon as a designated player. Instead of setting up Sergio Aguero and Lionel Messi as he did for Argentina on his two international assists, Pavon would then help set up Zlatan Ibrahimovic for a half season or more. And then, perhaps as early as the January window, Pavon could get its money back and then some. Yet while Almirón's tow to Atlanta United was the idea of playing for Tata Martino, the Galaxy's coach already has managed Pavon. There should be little transition period, although we've seen that can be tricky in the case of Atlanta's new boy, Pity Martinez. The Galaxy are already a contender for MLS Cup, but LAFC stands in their way. That the one club in the league, sorry San Jose, who the Galaxy cannot afford to let look like a clearly superior side. The timing of this report serves some notice that it could be a vehicle to inspire bigger beats from the Gunners and other international suitors this early in the transfer window. The MLS window, after all, does not open again until July 9. Follow at Nicolas Mandola. Aston Villa have signed Netherlands international Anwar El Ghazi on a permanent transfer after he dazzled during a loan spell in their promotion push last season. El Ghazi, 24, spent last season on loan from French side Lille. The winger scored in the championship playoff final as Villa beat Derby County 2-1 at Wembley and were promoted back to the Premier League after a three-season absence. It is believed the transfer fee for El Ghazi is around $10 million before a permanent deal had been done. El Ghazi professed his love for Villa, "I love the club and I love the fans. This club is amazing, his mixture of pace, trickery and superb crosses made El Ghazi an instant fans favorite at Villa Park, and along with Albert Adumach and Jack Grealish he provided plenty of service for on loan striker and top goalscorer Tammy Abraham. Anwar proved everybody at Wembley how good a player he can be for Aston Villa," Villa boss Dean Smith said. "He's ready for the step up to the Premier League. He's a young player who has an awful load of potential. It's now my job and the job of the coaching staff and Anwar himself to fulfill the potential that he undoubtedly has. He'll be a great addition to the squad for next season. El Ghazi came through Ajax's famed academy but has been a little bit of a late bloomer in his career. He now has the platform to kick on and become a regular in the PL with Villa, and his flowing style of play suits Smith's philosophy and the players around him perfectly. Villa will now be working hard to sign their other loan stars from last season, Abraham, Tyron Mings, Courtney Hause and Axel Tuanzebe on permanent deals as they aim to keep their exciting young squad together in the top flight. Follow at jpw_nbigsports. Christian Pulisic is ready to roll for the USMNT as they kick off their Gold Cup campaign against Guyana on June 18 in St. Paul, Minnesota. But where should Greg Berhalter play him? More, how should USMNT line up? Pulisic, 20, is the leading star of this team and after two disappointing defeats and plenty of criticism over the past week, the US need him now more than ever. He has yet to play a part in the two friendlies and that is likely because he needed a bit of a rest after a busy end to the Bundesliga season and because he wants to be as fresh as possible before heading to his new club Chelsea in July. For more of the last few years, Pulisic has been handed the No. 10 shirt and has played in that role or used of a central striker for the US. He has spent time on the wing too, and that is his natural position and it is where the USMNT should keep him. Pulisic's ability to beat defenders 1-for-1 is his main strength. Bärhalter must focus on getting him in those positions as much as possible and not worrying about having to track back and defend if an inexperienced fullback is playing behind him. When it gets the latter stages of the Gold Cup, which the USMNT hope to be playing, a part of Pulisic could be man-marked in the central attacking role and therefore the US would lose its main attacking weapon. But if he starts out wide, it is a lot tougher for him to be shut down. His dribbling ability often sees him cut inside, so even if he does start out on the left, naturally he drifts 10 bis 15 yards inside to create space for himself and wreak havoc for opposition defenders. With intelligent central midfielders such as Tyler Adams and Weston McKennie around him, they will slide over and plug any gaps out wide to balance the defensive side of the team and that will allow Pulisic more freedom to roam. Simply put, Bärhalter needs to play Pulisic out wide and not in the central attacking role. He can cause more damage in that role and he will give the USMNT a better balance in attack as he feeds off Jozy Altidore in links up midfield in attack. Instead of floating behind Altidore or whoever starts up top, Pulisic is better as an out-and-out winger with a clear mission to disrupt the fullback he's up against. Because of his incredible skill on the ball and eye for a pass, it is tempting to get Pulisic on the ball as much as possible. But that slows things down too much for him. He's at his best with the drop of the shoulder, a surging run inside and a killer pass or shot from the edge of the box. Everyone connected with the USMNT will be hoping they see plenty of that this summer. Follow at jpw_nbigsport. The Premier League transfer window is officially open again and that means one thing. Transfer reports are going to start kicking up a few notches. Video Premier League highlights. Here's a look at some of the latest gossip from around the PL. Corriere dello Sport in Italy say that Paul Pogba has agreed to move back to his former club Juventus but the Italian champions will need to sell plenty of players to sign the Manchester United midfielder. Pogba, 26, joined United from Juve in the summer of 2016 for $110 million but has had a topsy-turvy second spell at Old Trafford under Jose Mourinho now Ole Gunnar Solskjaer. With Solskjaer linked with moves for multiple central midfielders already during the transfer window, it appears that if a suitable deal to move Pogba on can be made, he will be able to leave United. Juve will reportedly look to move on Mario Mandzukic, Joao Cancelo, Juan Cuadrado and Mattia Perin to fund the move but there will be no rush on the move as they don't currently have a manga. Maurizio Sarri is expected to leave Chelsea to take charge of Juve in the coming days and then Juve will be able to kick on with the transfer business for the summer. If United can get back most of the $110 million they spent on Pogba, that would be a very good deal. In an ideal world they would get a little cash and maybe Paulo Dybala in exchange for Pogba. Although his displays picked up when Mourinho departed and Solskjaer arrived, the Frenchman's form regressed at the end of the season and he really is at the crossroads in his career. Does he stay at United and lead their rebuild in a possible return to glory? Or does he return to Juve where he can help them challenge for the European title alongside Cristiano Ronaldo and settle for the relative safety of winning Serie A year in, year out? Portuguese teenager João Félix is one of the hottest properties in world soccer and Manchester City is pushing ahead with their attempts to sign the Benfica midfielder. Benfica's chairman has admitted that Félix could be sold this summer, and Portuguese newspaper records say that Man City have offered wages in excess of $33.70 million over 5 years. The attacking midfielder is said to have a release clause of $133.10 million, but neither City nor Man United, who are also in the hunt for Félix, have triggered that clause. Félix, 19, was part of Portugal's squad which won the UEFA Nations League over the weekend and his attacking prowess, close control and work ethic means he is perfect for Pep Guardiola's style of play. In many ways he's a younger Bernardo Silva, and with David Silva not getting any younger and Phil Foden yet to fully flourish into a first team regular, this is an area where City could strengthen. The figures are eye-watering, but Félix is one of the best young talents in Europe and if City want to continue their domination they have to sign players of his ilk. With Leroy Sane potentially heading out of the door this summer, the transfer fee may not be as daunting as it seems right now. Follow at jpw_nbigsportsday 4 of the 2019 Women's World Cup is here as Canada enters the tournament. More Women's World Cup news. The hosts from 4 years ago were knocked out in the quarterfinals on home soil and will fancy their chances of making a deep run in this tournament. Led by captain and record goalscorer Christine Sinclair, they face an underdog Cameroon side to open up group play. Argentina and Japan square off in Group D on Monday as England beat Scotland on Sunday to take control of that group. Japan are also favored to go far in this tournament and it will likely be between them and England to finish top of the group. Remember, you can watch every single game live online in Spanish via Telemundo Deportes. All you have to do is click on the links below. Live, watch every single 2019 Women's World Cup game. Here is your full schedule for Monday, June 10 at the Women's World Cup. 2019 Women's World Cup Schedule Group D, Argentina v. Japan, 12 Uhr mittags. ET, Stream Live Group E, Canada v. Cameroon, 3 Uhr nachmittags. Punkt. ET, Stream Live Follow at jpw_nbigsports Let's Block Ads. Why?